What a great story that was. Julian joins us again, the CEO of Our Place. Julian, you've been here for just over a year now. You've had some time to get a feel for the capital city and the people who call this wonderful place home. Your impressions of Victoria?
Yeah, I have some pretty strong impressions of this, of Greater Victoria. I've lived and worked in many cities in our country and in other countries, and so a few things strike me about Greater Victoria. One is the concern of people here for those that are less fortunate and who are struggling in life. They're a real deep, genuine concern. Secondly is action about those concerns, doing things to actually help people, and you know, whether it's providing housing for people who are homeless or you know, overdose services for people who have addiction challenges. And the third thing I really notice here is the generosity. I've never ever lived or worked anywhere where there's such collective generosity. People give so much to us in terms of donations and their time as volunteers and in-kind gifts. It is actually overwhelming sometimes, the what I call the unconditional generosity of people in this region.
When you look back on the past year, I'm sure there's many achievements, things that you're proud about. Just keeping the doors open and the lights on is one of them, but what stands out to you in terms of things you're proud about looking back over the last year that's been probably most difficult in Our Place's history?
Yeah, the things I'd be most proud of in the last year, one was that we stayed open throughout COVID, and we're, you know, because we are a service that for some people is the only place they come, so we were there for them day and night for the whole of COVID. Secondly, that we housed over 500 people. We stepped up and we manage and operate most of the transitional housing in the city, and we house an additional 500 people. So that was a huge achievement, I think, for us.
How important is the support that you're receiving tonight? Without the donations, without the people buying those silent auction prizes, where does that leave Our Place if you don't get that support?
It leaves us closed. It's absolutely vital. I mean, it's no exaggeration to say that if we didn't have the kind donations that folk give us, we wouldn't be able to serve our meals, for example. You know, this is a vital meal service in our city, 3 meals a day, 7 days a week. That is funded entirely by donations.
Julian, thank you for the conversation. Don't go anywhere. We have much more still to come. You're watching a special Hungry Hearts broadcast here on Check. We're back in a moment.